Experimental weaving question are based off of this. This is a flying gyroscope, and when you throw it, it spins and it goes and it creates lift that way. And the way that I had to build the wings on the airplanes, they don't spin because I do not possess technology that would make that possible. If I could do this again, I would try to design a way to make them spin because I believe that was a factor in the stability of the way this flew. Official airplane testing goggles.
I must say, it's quite crisp.
Airplane wings work on a fairly simple principle, and that principle, called Bernoulli's principle, states that the faster that a liquid or a gas moves, the less dense it becomes. And you see, an airplane wing, it's curved on the top and flat on the bottom, usually, and that makes it the air traveling over the top will have to move faster than the air traveling under the bottom, and therefore it will be less dense. And if it's less dense on the top, the airplane, or the wing, will rise. And so, in this test, the wings have the same surface area on both sides. So, they will, there's no lift. It's called a symmetrical airfoil. And the symmetrical airfoil has the same surface area on both sides, and so the pressure on the top of the wing is going to be the same as the pressure on the bottom of the wing, and therefore it won't provide any upward lift or negative lift. And so that's good for our purposes because it still will fly, and the only provider of lift will be this in the back, and I've angled that down to make sure no lift is created. And so that means if the experimental wings produce any lift, that will show, because this will not produce any lift and will stay horizontal until gravity acts on it. And if the experimental wings in question provide any lift, it will climb until gravity acts on it, and eventually it will either stall or just hit the ground and crash. These planes are modified so that they provide as little lift as possible. So the experimental wings or the conventional wings are only the sole providers of lift. And it also provides a more smooth and even flight, a more level flight, rather than having it go up and stall several times.
The farthest that the control airplane flew was 2,370 centimeters. The shortest it flew was 890 centimeters. The farthest that the experimental plane flew was 1,003.1 centimeters. And the shortest it flew was 229.8 centimeters. There were 15 trials done with each airplane, and every single time the control airplane flew farther and smoother than the experimental airplane. The experimental airplane spun out of control every single time, where the control airplane flew smooth and even the entire distance of the gymnasium. The control airplane has a clear advantage over the experimental airplane. It obviously works better, which means my hypothesis was wrong and that the experimental wings do not work better than the control wings.
Shims. S-H-I-M.
Can I just call him He-She's?
Rising up, back on the street. Crouch down. Look, what?
You don't need that much of a close-up.
Really? 36. We're still stranded in this weird gymnasium. The pictures of weird children on the walls.
Nothing to do
with the
airplane ground.
I don't know why we're in here. We're ever gonna get out, but we can see the zombies outside. And we're gonna have to do something soon. At least they gave us these airplanes to help us keep busy. You know, when the zombie apocalypse is happening right before your eyes, you need something to keep you sane. Unless you'll totally lose it and end up becoming one of them. Gone outside once, almost didn't make it back. It's so hot in here. What are you still doing here? Movie's over. Go. Go home. Go.